This is under Karma Yoga. In this sloka, Bhagavan says, all actions in all situations are performed by gunas of Prakriti. He who is completely deluded by ego thinks I am the doer. That's why he says they are ignorant. Ignorant of what? Soul. They think we are body. They don't have the thought we are Atma. And all actions are performed by the gunas of Prakriti, the nature. It's created by material energy. That's created by God. God has created material energy too. And there are different functions in the material energy. For example, natural biological functions taking place like digestion, heartbeat. Then certain actions we think and we perform. For example, speaking, writing, singing. And both the actions, the biological functions and the actions what we think and perform, they are done by body, mind and senses. All the three. All this from Prakriti, created in the nature, which are bound by gunas. What gunas? Sattvic, Rajas, Tamas. Sattvic, you think goodness. Then Rajas, passion. Then Tamas, ignorance. So the body is a part of Mother Nature from which it is created. So material energy is the doer of everything. But what do we say? I am the doer. So it is guna. It is Prakriti which does everything. So the soul identifies itself with body. He is under illusion. And he thinks that he is the doer. So we have different personalities. Like if you take Ravana, he finds Ravana passion, that is Rajas Guna. He wanted to have everything for himself and he was arrogant. And he was doing for selfish motives. And if you take Kumbhakarna, Tamas, he never attempted to do anything. He kept on sleeping. So there was no initiative from him. There was no motivation from him. And he never felt that he should do something. He should contribute something to the society. So here, Vibhishan Sattvic. Vibhishan understood that they are... Ravanan is not doing good thing. He is taking away someone's property, someone's wife, and he surrendered himself to Bhagavan. So that is what Sattvic Guna does. Sattvic Guna drives the person to do it. So soul, each one views soul from different point of view. So the people who are ignorant, they think that they are the doers. It is like when there are two trains and one is not moving and we are sitting in that and there is another train coming in the opposite direction, moving in opposite direction, and we think that our train is moving. This is how the actions are taking place. That is, we think I am the doer, but I am not the doer. Then who does it? It is the gunas of Prakriti. So when, how do we understand the truth? When we remove ego and when we surrender to God, remove ego and surrender to God, then you will understand the truth. The truth is that the train in which I am sitting is not moving. The other one is moving. So, I am the non-doer. And there may be a question in our mind, when I am a non-doer, why I am having the karma palan? Why the law of karma brings action, reactions to me when I am not the doer? The answer is, and soul take, we say soul takes different births and different body, but I am not the doer. Why I am undergoing that? The example here is a coach driven by horse. There will be a driver controlling the horse, and that coach meets with an accident. So what happens? Actually, the horse is pulling the cart and the driver is initiating, that is guiding that horse. But when there is any accident takes place, then the driver is blamed, not the horse. So this is what happens to our soul. Soul drives, it gives direction, it directs actions of senses, mind and intellect. So we have seen already about intellect, we have learnt already about intellect in the previous lokas. The intellect controls mind, and intellect is provided with good knowledge, spiritual knowledge. So the intellect getting such type of knowledge and giving direction to mind. Don't do that, it is wrong. Do this, this is right. So the soul directs the actions of senses. When you touch the fire also, we immediately withdraw. Having realized the heat, we immediately withdraw our fingers. So how does it take place? Because there is a direction given. Withdraw your hand. So the senses, mind and intellect, which are all the causes for any action, and they are directed by soul. So in that way, soul is responsible, and sense, mind and intellect works based on the instructions from soul. So this is how the soul is responsible for the actions, and soul takes different births as per our karma phalan, the karmic reactions. So you should have knowledge about soul. So to get that knowledge that we are Atma, when you get that Atma, you are away from darkness. You are no more ignorant. So you will understand and you will know. You will know, keep Atma away from gunas. Don't get your soul entangled in gunas. So how to keep your Atma away from this? That is what Lord Krishna explains here. So first you understand the truth that we are Atma, and how Atma is responsible for the actions. Because it directs actions of senses, mind and intellect. In 28th sloka, Bhagavan says, O mighty armed, that is, he is addressing Arjuna. So mighty armed, he is explaining prakriti. Prakriti is divided into 24 components, 5 elements, 5 mediums like sound and the smell, touch, 5 sense organs, 5 organs of actions, and 4 internal organs. So all this together called prakriti, created by God. Prakriti is also a maya. So in the next sloka, that is in 28th sloka, he talks about one who knows the truth, how does he behave towards prakriti? So he says, one who knows truth about divisions of gunas as well as their functions, recognize interplay of gunas, that is, how you react to the objects on the earth. It depends on your guna. And it depends on your guna and what you perceive from the nature. So they interact with each other, the object on the earth and the gunas. They interact with the, and when you are attached to the objects, what happens? You get entangled in that. You develop attachment towards that. Such people are under ego. Those think that they are the doers. So when that ego is removed, they will understand. So how can they remove the ego? Only by removing the ego and surrendering to God. Then they will understand that prakriti, that nature causes actions. It is not I. So that knowledge has to be developed. So that laws of karma to be understood. So when you say laws of karma, we have seen in the previous sloka how the soul directs the actions of senses, mind and intellect. So the one who understands this will be out of ignorance. When you are out of ignorance, you are not under ego. Then you will understand only God is the doer. So that illusion, ego creates that illusion. So that has to be removed. So if you contemplate on this teaching, then we find that we are reducing the anger, fear, stress and all negative emotions. Because you are becoming, there's a clarity developing in your mind. So what happens? You become humble. You are surrendering your ego, you are humble. So you are able to receive the knowledge. When you receive the knowledge, naturally you become humble. You accept the teachings from others. Due to ego, we have fear. Because we should be in a position to compete with them. Am I competent enough? So we have all this fear. So out of fear we have stress. All are removed. Once we remove our ego and once we understand that we are not the doer. So the humility has to be there. And there should be a knowledge that prakriti causes actions, not I. Bhagavan wants the ignorant people to develop this knowledge in their mind. It is like buying a flower. Suppose you are seeing a very bright, colorful, you know, a flower with good fragrance. You get attracted and your mind gives in direction because you are sensing and you are using the sense organs with that. You are giving direction to mind and that mind buys, asks you to buy, then intellect buys it. So what happens? You are getting into that actions and you are buying that. So what all available on the earth around us in the nature make us do that action. So this is what Bhagavan says. So prakriti causes actions, it is not I. So it's very, if you understand this and follow, we can control ourselves from all temptations in our life. 29th sloka. In 29th sloka, Bhagavan, 29th sloka. In 29th sloka, Bhagavan says, people deluded by gunas of prakriti are attached to gunas and actions. The wise person does not disturb those fools, he says, who are of limited knowledge. And he advises the wise people how to lead them. Instead of preaching them, you stand as an example for them. So the jnanis have to be careful in setting the path. So that is what Lord Krishna says in this. So he is bringing